Karma as well, in terms of the support role.
It's also 1 4 out of 5. Now, I think
great
that's
ratio.
Correlation rather than causation.
Okay.
Because, for instance, in the Misfits series, I feel like Misfits probably had that one anyway. From how their lead was constructed, it wasn't from the Shen.
So,
right?
Huma were the only ones that then lost. Shame on you, Huma.
Well, that's the thing is, I feel like when it's won, it hasn't been just because of the Shen, right? It's not like, hey,
it's
Shen's
been on the winning
great.
Team.
Yeah, exactly.
Not, it has won for the team.
Mm-hmm.
See, same page again. All right, picks and bans underway. Swain, Aurelion Sol. Better call Sol next time, not this time. Vlad,
I swear Pulse is still in the studio somewhere.
Shane, not going to be able to be first picked because he's been banned. It's borrowing.
Are we giving him a rise with you stealing his lines?
It's borrowing content. No, Rise hasn't been banned yet. we'll find out if it's available. Sivir, once again, taken off the table. So Irelia is up, which means Wicked could play it, and it is meta-relevant these days. I can't see it in his match-played history. Oh, that would be a blast from the past if I got to shoutcast Wicked's Irelia. That would make me quite happy. We'll find out if that's going to be the case. Jhin, the final ban. So two ADCs, a bunch of mid laners and top laners. Jungle pool completely untouched.
Taken away. Now, will Wicked play the Malphite into it? He knows... like, it's been played into him, and he's played it a billion times, I feel like. Because whenever Irelia is around, Malphite's around. Just for wombo combo goodness.
I hope not.
I kind of hope not, but I kind of hope so at the same time. Like, let's go crazy again.
When was the last time we saw Malphite? Let me search. I'll tell you right now.
So there was one, I believe. I want to say it was LCK. No LPL.
Well, you're like halfway.
I saw it in one of the Asian regions a couple of weeks back because I
went. That really doesn't narrow it down. Braum and Karma. So once again, we're going to see mid lane Karma. This time it'll be in Cap's hands. Brazil most recently played Malphite, 6.12. Winter playoffs.
Am I looking at that LPL?
China
Acorn
also
played
did.
Yes. Acorn that was the game
it.
I was thinking of that I saw.
It was a loss.
Saint hey, I didn't say
Gaming
one.
Taking on Aimee. And I may win the game because Malphite's boring and didn't work.
Well, there's the Olaf.
Swapping champions, yeah, really. If Olaf Ashe is locked in, that means Millennium is going to be running, Nerve running game one. And Nuxalot ran the Zyra. So let's see what Nerve round out the next rotation with. Because you got a very heavy run at you comp.
Okay, there is the Ashe. So, Nerve. What are we looking for? Jungle AD carry. Last game we saw Trundle Ezreal come out on this
rotation.
Yeah.
Like, would they just steal Millennium's draft?
That's what I'm thinking.
Hey, we like that. We can play it better. Let's just take it.
Yeah, it's like, hey, we beat you when you were playing this. Let's rub it in and get the win with it. I don't know whether that's particularly a great way to go about drafting for game two of a series.
Lost your pen?
Lost my mind at this point. I have a spare.
Oh, yes. Nice. Nice. Three
prepare
pens on this
fail.
Desk, actually.
Oh, fail to prepare. Prepare to fail. Yep. You've got to make sure you got pens.
Maybe your pen mechanics just suck.
It's like an island of pens right here.
That you will never know. Right. Last few seconds before Nerve lock in the rotation. Trundle and Gragas is the option. So Wicked will be running Trundle into Irelia. Caps. No, it's ADC will be the last pick.
Yeah.
So, upset. I mean, Lucian is up. Looking at most
Ezreal.
Played. Ezreal as well, again. And that would actually work, I think. Again, disengage, peel away.
Mm-hmm. It's the same composition if they run the Ezreal.
Just Millennium different order?
Played. Yeah. It's just the Gragas and the Ezreal would be backwards. So, depending on what Millennium pick up here, we're looking for support and mid lane. We may still see the Zyra come out. Masterwork is a Morgana player as he hovers it, though. So you could very well see that.
One game played, 3-2-8, this split. Not quite the same level of disengage that Zyra brings to the table, but significantly more offensive pressure, I feel. That Dark Binding, especially when comboed with Ash Arrow, when comboed with Gold Card or Irelia Stun, that just screams pick comp to me. Victor makes it a little more well-rounded, I feel.
It
brings
does
a bit
make
more team fight power.
more well-rounded. The Hover of the Twisted Fate had me intrigued because Pretty was playing a lot of Twisted Fate back at the beginning of Spring Split. Wasn't to be in this game, though. I like the Victor gives him extra wave clear. The only problem I can see is outside of Ash, you have no way of starting a fight that you want to get the Irelia, the Olaf into. I feel like Millennium, we're picking a composition and then we're like, well, we're picking to deny Wicked first and then went, ooh, well, we want Olaf out of the jungle. And now they've struggled and are in a situation where they require a little bit more when it comes to engage and damage and they can't actually find it from all of their roles.
Yeah, I think though, if they find targets between Tabs and Masterwork, the Ash Arrow and the Dark Binding just make it so easy for Irelia and Olaf to kill people. But then again, they have to find those arrows, get past a pillar, get past a barrel, and get through a Braum.
Heavy disengage. Yeah.
Very, very difficult. So it was a Lucian. Minor change here to Nerve's bottom lane. Lucian instead of Ezreal. What do you make of the Nerve composition? Very disengage heavy, very peel and kite and fight.
Disengage heavy. I mean, it's a strange composition because I think the Ezreal probably would round it out a little better. The only thing is, like, Lucian's obviously going to give him a little bit more in the lane, but into Ash, you've got to be careful because, you know, obviously that level 6 point is a deadly one. So I'm looking forward to seeing if we get a lane swap or a 2v2 to start out with this one. And we can see whether Millennium can turn it back around and even this series up.
Will Millennium be able to pick up a point and make their shot at number 2 seed a little better? Hashtag MIL win. Jump onto Twitter for the last game of week 4 from the Stress Shotcast. Or will Nerve be able to pick up their first series victory all summer long? Hashtag NRV win.
Please not all summer long. That was a really bad song by Kid Rock.
Never listened to him, so I'll have to take a word for it.
You're probably more enlightened in life by doing that.
The only one I know was that bomb with the bar, the bang, da bang, diggy, diggy. Is that him?
I believe so. Well, Millennium, they're going to believe in a four-man gang. They got him.
Masterwork has flashed. Undertone, Exhaust. Millennium have thrown everything at Wicked. Wicked's already flashed away. Undertow. Volley. No more Undertow. First blood picked up by Kasei.
And it goes to Irelia. If there was a champion that you would want that to go to on this lineup, that is the exact one. I mean, now they can look to snowball Kasei from the top lane. Oh, Wicked. That's unfortunate. It was not expecting
is.
The 4 or 5 man play into the top side.
Well, Masterwork, he connected. If it was Zyra, it would not have hit.
Yeah, that's fair. Millennium used to do that play a lot, though. Would just group up and go, hey, let's try and catch somebody. what is going on in this game?
Nerve are going to put some pressure onto Pretty. Flash and Ghost burned already. Memento with a Body Slam Flash. That could be a low-level gank opportunity.
Yeah, that's like a one-buff gank potentially could come out for that if Pretty does push up. As you said, no summoners available. Now Masterwork has no summoners, and now they're in a 2v2. So basically, if Masterwork steps forward and gets hit by the Winter's Bite, Sinuke's a lot and upset are just going to kill him, pretty much. So they're probably going to get heal out of this lane fairly efficiently. Caps hit level 2. He's going to try and kill Pretty.
Oh, so much damage.
Oh, man.
No combat summoner. Takes the tower shot on the minion. Ooh. Woo, Caps. Dancing with death there for a little bit, but manages to make it out alive. And Pretty, he decides to stick around. 6 CS to 10. Kasei with an additional longsword. Just some extra trading potential into Wicked.
Trading potential and also forcing Wicked not to farm because he's going to take a trade every single time. And like Wicked is not going to be able to win out on these trades. Trundle later on with the Subjugate and all that is going to be able to somewhat deal with what Kasei has to offer, but it is a rough scenario and setting to be in. Joko, however, last game he faced a little bit of presence from Caps trying to come down into his jungle on that Aurelion Salt, but for now should be okay.
Yeah, Joko, 8 CS, Ghost has just become available, as he's done a full clear. Double buffs available. And Kaze's doing a good job pulling ahead of Wicked, even in this mid lane, although Caps should be able to pull ahead. He's got about 5 minions in front of him. Some potential support from Joko, but pretty dancing on the very, very razor's edge safety.
If he pushes for... Oh, Joko's here, okay.
Joko's here. 2v2. Caps is looking for the kill. Pretty's in trouble. Already secured. Now Joko's looking for Caps. Down to 200 hit points. The undertow. Reckless swing. Teleport from Kaze. Memento's the target. Kaze dashes forward to the Blade Surge. The tower takes him down. It's a double kill for Joko. I think he even reset his buffs. Undertow doesn't catch Wicked. Masterwork. Dark Binding won't find a target as the Unbreakable will be used to block some damage. Wicked's running for his life. And it will be another kill secured by Millennium. Donated to Kaze. 2-0-1.
Well, we were talking about how would you give the resources over to Irelia and Olaf at the same time and still be able to take fights well. If you get 4 kills at 4.5 minutes in, this is the exact kind of start that they would have needed for this composition to work. It's a tough composition to pull out, and he's one of those ones.
Oh, what a shot! Tormented Soil applies the Thunderlord's tabs. He's got a black shield to prevent at least those concussive blows, but Upset. Gonna be very upset with that trade.
So Pretty getting punished for not having his flash available. That's a fairly straightforward one. But in came the early teleport. Wicked came in way later. The ward had only just been dropped from Memento and co. I believe that was what Wicked was waiting on. He didn't want to TP into the back because there would be no real chance of him getting into the fight. Masterwork said he's a Morgana player. Typically, is good at setting up these roams. Didn't hit the binding, but was there for the exhaust on that exchange. And top lane, we are into a fight.
Let's do it again. Black Shield prevents any further follow-up onto Masterwork. Memento shows his face in the lane. Is unable to pick up a kill, though.
As I was going to say, this is one of these team compositions out of Millennium that you look at and you say, well, if it loses, it was a bad draft. Pretty much. So we've got to at least keep it realistic. If it wins, people will be like, great, they played it amazingly well. It was a great draft, a great composition. If it loses, not so much.
No, absolutely the truth. But luckily for Millennium, the advantage they built up and the tools of the composition allow them to play proactively now. Ash Arrow and Ragnarok and Ragnarol and Joko. Kaze's got double the CS of Wicked, more than, and 2 kills and assist.
On Irelia?
It's going to take
kind of disgusting.
Such a long time. What was Elfari's Trinity Force?
It was like
12 week?
Minutes. 12 minute Infinity Edge. Woo. Trinity Force. Caps wants Joko.
Oh, Caps is in trouble. Joko's yelling.
Caps is dead.
Gravity field's not going to matter. So, yeah, Pretty gets that one.
Yep.
And fifth kill.
That helps Pretty get back into this matchup now. This is going to be a fast game.
You say that now. You say that now, friend.
You're having flashbacks to Fnatic Origin.
No, you just forget which studio you're in and which teams you're watching. We'll see. We'll see.
Says the LCS caster that had an 80-minute game. What are you trying to pull on me?
Hopefully not a long one. Kaze. We'll get the Soul Flare out, rooted in place. A little bit of a passive, thanks to the Tenacity. Kaze, 100 HP. Wicked's going to look forward for the Chomp. Body Slam blocked by Joko, but the barrel cannot be. Pretty's Gravity Field results in nothing. And Memento at least gets a kill back for Nerve, keeping the goal to 1,600 difference at 7 minutes.
Yeah, it's still a big lead, but you can see already 2 components for Kaze. He was caught out in that exchange, was too far, too deep. And it gets punished for it, but 2 kills, still over double in CS. Man, Millennium still have a good setup for themselves. No teleport available for Kaze yet, but Nerve are going to have to turn this one around. That's the beginning of turning it around for them. We'll take another look. This was Kaze going aggressive. Level 6 to level 4. And Wicked
<That's>
managed
so
to flash
deep.
Himself away. I don't know why Kaze doesn't just run down there. I guess he feels like he can't outrun Caps in the lane with Memento. Wants to stick around Joko in case they can turn it around. But, I mean, Kaze was pretty much out in that scenario. Doesn't have his flash, I guess.
Yeah.
Wanted to take the route with more of his teammates in.
Yeah, I mean, sticking around Joko, I guess. Roam here from Tabs. ECA gonna connect, and Caps will die. Death Ray and Volley, Pretty gets it.
I was wondering what ECA was.
Yeah,
then.
I knew you were going to say it. Enchanted Crystal Arrow.
I got it after I thought about it.
Yeah.
Sounds like some kind of medical device, like an ECG.
Okay. Except it does the opposite.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. This is like clear.
Yeah, this one freezes your heart. And
I don't think we've quite perfected cryogenics yet. Not for Demolition Man, anyway.
Lissandra begs to differ.
I guess so. Have you seen Demolition Man?
Fantastic. The three shells?
Yeah,
how do you not know how to use
seashells?
the three seashells? She sells this seashells at the seashore.
This is how I know I'm not casting with Pulse.
Yes.
Because that movie was like way before Pulse's time.
It was, and it was in my childhood. It's one of my childhood favorites. Wesley Snipes and Sylvester Stallone. Yep, they're cryogenically frozen from the 90s. They wake up in the future, and get this, all restaurants are out of business, and Pizza Hut is
Taco Bell.
Fine. Is it Taco Bell?
Yeah, it's Taco Bell.
Oh.
Trevor, you failed me. I'm sorry.
I really think it's Pizza Hut.
No, it's Taco Bell.
You know what?
Sandra Bullock has a monologue about Taco Bell. I can promise you. Caps is about to get monologued on by Joko and his axes.
He will be. I mean, there's not a lot that Joko can do here to the Flash. Pretty con chase. See, Taco Bell didn't come to South Africa, so I think in South Africa it was Pizza Hut.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Taco Bell's not a thing in South Africa.
That'd be great. But then
I'm going to review this. Okay. I'm going to review this.
We're going to have to watch the South African version of Demolition Man.
If anybody else has watched Demolition Man, does anybody else remember it being Pizza Hut? We'll find out. We'll find out. Because this is like a thing. So
it is.
You know who sponsored the film. So we should probably stop talking about it at this point, though.
Unnamed fast food restaurant.
Yes, unnamed fast food restaurant.
Going to take themselves a Rift Herald. They were so close to predicting the future as well. If only they'd pick Donald Trump.
Stressy poo. We have confirmation from our producer that the European release of the film replaced Taco Bell with Pizza Hut.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yep.
I always watched British TV. Okay.
What this means is you watched the original, and I watched the edited one, and I've never heard the Sandra Bullock speech.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Oh, this is fantastic.
What, so we're both right? I don't know how to feel about this.
We are. We're both right, but we're also both wrong because there's a game going on, which we're kind of employed to talk about. Millennium, 2K Gold Up. 2 towers to 2 in the delayed lane swap?
Yes.
After Wicked just got pooped on because of the early game?
I mean,
Nerve swapped away.
He got 1v4'd in the jungle, which, I mean, you could say he should be warding out for, because Millennium do make that play fairly often. Millennium right now, though, they've got themselves another dragon. The lead has increased to just about 2k gold, and a slightly larger lead than Millennium had. So they are still kind of advancing what they've got. When coming up to 11 minutes, there was a boot spy by Kaze. He would have been on for the early Triforce if he hadn't have done that.
But the other way around.
Still a Zeal and the recipe cost away.
So it could be close to 12 minutes. Nerve are invading. A little bit blind, actually. Joko throws an undertow.
Forget it's not Zeal anymore.
Yeah. Oh, it's Stinger. That's right. Two patches, right?
So,
Stinger plus the combined cost. Nerve playing very brave, actually. Not backing away from the jungle, invading for the Raptor camp. Have the numbers advantage. And they're going to back away now. So the last outer turrets are in the mid lane. And you've got two very good wave clear mids, Karma and Victor. This could be problematic, as Mountain Drake is highlighted by our observational team.
So the problem is, like, you have an Irelia. I say the problem for Nerve. They have to go against an Irelia that is crushing your side lane.
Yeah.
So what Wicked's doing here is trying to drag Irelia top, but Irelia's bringing Olaf with her. Unless Joko steps on a ward, which he does right now, which now tells Wicked he has to back himself away, would normally have been a good thing for Millennium, but now that Wicked had the information, they can't set a trap.
Oh, but Pretty is going to get trapped. Surrounded. Wicked on top. Caps and Memento coming down. Body slam, flash. The barrel sends Pretty the wrong direction. Masterworks trying to run up. Siphon Power gives a little bit of a shield to Pretty, but it's not going to be enough. Pretty's going for a run. The Ghost and the Flash gets Pretty out safely. That was Soaz levels of magical escape. Winter's Bite after a flash from Sir Nukes-a-Lot. That was optimistic.
Very optimistic at that point. Millennium now pushing or not pushing through mid lane anymore. They've slowed down after 13 minutes of pretty much being in control. Kaze's out on the side lane, still has a massive CS lead for himself. But it's not quite the aggression. I was saying this could be a fast game. It has tempered itself.
I told you so.
Why are you dancing?
Because it's the I told you so
okay,
dance.
That's fine.
Yep. Called it. Called it. Can't make those predictions at 7 minutes.
That's true.
Yep. Safety and things make it not true. So Wicked got himself the Ninja Tabby. Jurem's Fist, first item on Trundle. Triforce, not quite as early as Alfari's the other day. But Kaze doing very well. I think he's got enough gold to complete that. Yes, 1,000 in his back pocket.
Still fast.
Oh, yes. 14 minutes. And the mid-outer is being sieged. Joko's body blocking upsets Culling. And that will keep Tabs alive. 121 CS. Enchanted Crystal Arrow available. And the rest of Millennium starting to group up around this mid lane. So an arrow from base could potentially happen. There's a teleport for Kaze too.
The thing is, there are only three people mid, as you said. TP was there, but no real easy TP positions to come into the fight. Man, this is a tough one. There was a I'm coming ping onto a ward that was hidden behind Braum's minimap icon. So there is a possibility of that TP coming through.
Braum's
there are
big
a couple
head
by the sides. Yeah, exactly. The shield was having the ward stand behind him, so we couldn't really see it.
I quite like Millennium's vision. Pretty nice pink ward behind the red buff in Nerve's side of the jungle, and then just a couple of wards behind Nerve's champions. So if Millennium wanted to play aggressive, the option was there. Especially now that Kaze's got that Triforce completed. Hex Core is up to level 2, plus the Lucy Boots for Pretty. BF Sword and Zeal. So Millennium have got all these item power spikes that are just one step ahead of their opposite numbers in most lanes.
New ward gets placed. This one we've seen.
Yeah, Cap's seen that one, right?
Yeah, that one Cap's now knows, so they can sweep that out. There is a sweeper on Nuxalot that is still available, but he's recalling, so he's going to get himself wards back available on his Sightstone. He's got himself a pink ward, all the good things that a support needs at this point.
So I want to give some credit to Nerve for slowing down the hemorrhaging once Millennium pulled ahead, because Nerve initiated that lane swap, traded some towers, and with the exception of Wicked, are farming evenly. Wicked, of course, can't really go toe-to-toe with Kaze. There's a two-level difference. It's Jurem's versus Triforce, and you can see the support that needs to come up.
Just bring everyone.
Yes.
It doesn't matter.
It's stalling the game, right? It was a 2k gold lead 7-8 minutes ago. It's still a 2k gold lead.
Yeah, it is. Now, though, the lead in the solo lane has bounced up to 50 CS now.
Yeah.
Which is akin to what it was earlier. A little bit bigger.
Halfway, Flame Horizon. You could call it a Cinder Horizon.
Yeah, like Ember Horizon.
An Ember Horizon. I quite like
that. I don't think we should do that, because it's not about a fire or a flame. It's about the player, so...
but why don't we just add another layer to it?
I think there would be a lot of people that would be like, you're just trying to reach. And I'm just saying. Flame fans would probably...
Flame me.
Yeah. Nothing new there.
Yeah, this would start it. Maybe it would be Ember me. Mountain Drake picked up here by Millennium. Second one. That's actually a really big problem for Nerve. Yes, they can slow the game down now, but when Millennium decide to play for inner turrets in bottom and middle, or when they go for that outer turret, when they look for Baron, those mountain objective damage stacks up so quickly. And look at Olaf, Irelia, Ashe. Like, they are going to shred through anything that they set their sights on.
Yeah, as soon as Irelia pushes up to this outer tower, it's pretty much dead. There's not a whole lot of plays that Nerve can do without focusing three people up to that top side, in which case Millennium takes something across the map. You can see they got three people on the bottom side.
I like the confusion. Millennium across the map?
No, I was taking a moment to see where Upset and the rest of Nerve were heading, because there's no dragon, no towers, but they were moving as this three-man pack. They're still doing it. Look, they're going over mid lane. They're trying to come in behind.
Real question is, where's Memento with Flash? Because Body slam, Gragas barrels. Really the only form of engage.
It really against the turret?
Yeah. I say that like it's a bad thing, but Gragas engage is very good. if Memento can find the right angle, and then combo that into a Bromstun or Trundle Pillar, and obviously that's how you can win these team fights. Got to be so careful, because Irelia and Olaf want to be bounced closer. So, hit me.
Well, a lot of the time you won't hit the Olaf as well, just because of the ult. So sometimes you'll see it whiff. We'll see whether that happens if Joko manages to pop his ult in time. So, tower goes over to Irelia, as to be expected. Again, we're at a point where nearly double CS for the top laners. Wicked is really struggling in this matchup ever since the beginning of the game. Of course, got caught out in a 1v4 in his own jungle.
And they got caught a few times later as well.
Yes.
I mean, gank attempts, making use of the strong lanes. I think some credit to Millennium for making those additional kills happen. But the one thing that Millennium have not kept up is that vision. So we're cresting 20 minutes. We're moving comfortably into the mid game. And the deep-ish vision is getting a little shallower. There's two pink wards around Baron, or at least the Baron side of the river. It's a very defensive wards from Nerve. So slow and steady on the side of Millennium.
Slow and steady. We'll see if it wins the race, because they can only draw. So it's a little unlucky. Sometimes sayings don't always work out, Trevor.
No, but it's quite sad, actually.
Oh, right. Ash Arrow on Memento.
Connects
no follow-up
Memento.
Yet.
Pretty and Joker, they come in range. Chaos Storm needs one more tick. A flash away from Memento. Pretty's not going to be able to catch him, though. And I think he got the blue buff as well on the way out.
But he's chunked enough that mid lane can now get pushed up as well. Pretty's going to push up the bottom lane. Irelia is soaking farm in the top side. Again, all of this is allowing Millennium to extend their lead.
Clean and controlled League of Legends from Millennium. Once they got the lead, they didn't overextend recklessly, didn't overextend and put themselves in a dangerous position. Though, as I'm saying that...
They didn't yet, yeah.
As I'm saying that, 20 minutes and 20 seconds, three-man Baron. We talked about how much damage they have. There's two Mountain Drakes. Nerve, they're aware of it. Masterworks looking to zone. Sweeper comes out, and Millennium, they're forced to peel away.
Okay, the peel back actually tells you that Millennium at least respect what Nerve are wanting to bring here. Wicked did have his TP available. And Kaze is now backing off to the top side. Coincidentally, Kaze is going the build that I quite like when it comes to wanting to be ahead and get further ahead. He's going for the Blade of the Rune King rather than the Ghost Blade, which is a lot more of, I'm just going to be able to duel anybody on this map, and nobody's going to be able to fight me. And Kaze's going to show us that.
Caps isn't going to be able to fight. Teleport's being channeled by Wicked. Don't finish that, Wicked. You might be in trouble. There's support coming from the jungle. Kaze decides not to stick around, realizing one and done, and the TP.
He just didn't have vision on where Memento was. He caught a glimpse of people coming up to the top side through the jungle, but didn't have exact vision on it, so he didn't want to go overly aggressive. Now he wants to go on Wicked.
Yeah, really good trade. Still a two-level advantage, 50 CS in the lead. Millennium, they set up around Baron. I think a lot of praise to Millennium for starting the Baron play. A few more seconds and maybe it would have been secured. But also to Nerve. The moment the champions disappeared from the minimap, Nerve respected the Baron play and engaged.
They did respect it. Millennium still playing around the bait on Baron. Seeing if they can lock it down. Oh, I've seen this play before.
Yeah, Kaze.
Game one all over again.
Caught out, a little too aggressive. Instead of it being upset this time around,
hang on.
It's the opposite. Kaze's putting a lot of damage. Forced a flash, not done yet. Barrel slows him down. Another equilibrium strike before a flash chomp gets the kill. Almost escaped, but Kaze tad too over aggressive.
Nearly got the kill in the 1v3 as well onto Karma. Karma just a little too utility strong when it comes to the shields that come out from him. Millennium still around this Baron, running out of ideas on what to do. Next dragon is about to come up, and it is another Mountain Drake.
Three for three.
Basically, Mount Doom for Nerve. I guess that's if it's Infernal that follows.
Yeah, I think that works. Well, Millennium uncontested on this one. Blade of the Rune King picked up Akaze. I want to duel anybody and win the 1v3. Maybe now he can.
Okay, what's it going to be? Is it Infernal? Is it going to be Mad
no,
Doom?
Observers, we need to see. Oh,
oh Asher, there's okay. a fight. Okay,
we'll get back to Dragon.
Sense.
Upset just sidesteps. That was a little uninspiring. A little dash over the wall. Thank you, Observers.
That's Mount Disappointment.
Mount Disappointment. Joko and Kaze. They rotate themselves up towards Baron. Pink Ward is in the pit.
However, three mountains and a cloud. You probably could call it like Mount Everest, because it's like the tallest mountain you can have. Like with clouds. Because mountains
windy
are in
up
the
there.
Clouds. Yeah, exactly.
I heard on Pokemon Go, that's where Articuno is hanging out.
There's like 10 people that are going to get that.
Yep.
It's like...
Well, it's Articuno. He's pretty hard to get.
That's
the whole
true.
Point.
It's like Ralph Fiennes. It's yeah. like, oh, I've got Pokemon Go.
Wonder nice. If it, I wonder if account sharing's a problem.
Hey. Just take,
does
take
anyone
my
know
phone.
Anyone going there? Just log into my account. Just grab me, Articuno.
I don't want to know where Moltres is then.
I don't
or
know.
Or Zapdos. That's,
Zapdos would be interesting. You can only capture in a thunderstorm. Good luck.
Just have to go out and hold your phone in the air.
Yeah. Zapdos, I mean, not Moltres. Got myself confused there.
It's okay.
But yeah, Millennium, they seem to be running out of ideas. They've secured a dragon safely. It's been the Baron Bay game for 6 minutes. No deep vision means not really setting up sieges on those inner turrets. And the game is stalling out, slowing down. Nerv can look to engage a Millennium as they're grouped up pretty well. And Kaze will have to TP in.
Oh, Joko might be caught.
Oh, Joko yells, oh no. Body slam catches Pretty. Very good Black Shield. Prevents the knockback. A full channel on the culling. Gets Joko down to 150 hit points. And Kaze, he doesn't even TP in.
Doesn't TP in. He wants a turret instead. They're going to look to trade this and try and cross map.
And that's good play. Kaze doesn't want to TP because his build says 1v1. If he TPs into a team fight, potentially that could go wrong. Instead, they managed to get themselves a tower at the cost of two summoner spells.
Yeah, it's still in the benefit of Millennium, always extending their lead. Has closed ever so slightly from Nerv being able to hold on, but whenever Millennium do make a play, it hasn't tended to backfire in this game. Kaze, we'll see if that holds true here. It looks like he was trying to go over the wall for a second.
And the thing is, like, that play just happened, I feel. Because Nerv decided to initiate.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh, arrow
dashed away.
Again.
Very nicely done. Upset, not afraid with that relentless pursuit. Still had flash and heal. But again, yeah, you know, Millennium, props to their calling, because the moment Nerv engaged, it felt like Kaze was just like, I want the tower, I'll get the tower, don't die. And that's basically what happened.
That is basically what happened. Also, I think I'm so gullible that if you told me Articuno was on top of a mountain, I'd probably go and climb it just to find out.
There's a level of trust there that needs
there
to be questioned at some point.
At this point, I'm like, I'm really not letting Trevor influence me on where I'm going to try and find my Pokemon.
Yeah, there was discussions around it on Reddit when the beta was coming out, about how you'd find different...
The legendaries?
Yep, different legendaries. Well, even just general Pokemon. They'll be hidden in different areas. Thought it was pretty cool.
Knowing my luck, I'll just be surrounded by Zubats.
Yeah. That's sad.
I know, right?
Mm.
It's the worst. Millennium. It's sad that this game slowed down. I thought we were in for a real fast-paced, messy...
Well, it has the potential to get explosive. At least if you're watching from a Millennium point of view. Because they can just Ash Arrow and then insta-gib somebody.
Oh, well, we'll
assuming
see.
It hits, actually, because Tabs has missed a few.
Ooh, upset!
Takes so much damage. Transcendent Blades from Kaze. Very, very late battle from Memento. Joko and the rest of Millennium are onto the inner turret. Chaos Storm is ticking away. Upset's going very low as the volley tags across. Wicked gets stunned on the tower before he's forced to flash away. Couple more autos and Millennium. They just brute force their way onto the objective.
Didn't need a kill for that one. Crowd Control landed. There was a lot of damage came through onto Lucian. You can see Kaze can just take anybody out. You see he dives into the fight. 1 minute 20 on that Cloud Drake. First Cloud Drake of the day, though. We have we've had every other Drake. A lot of them.
Yeah, six games of Challenger and ton of Infernals, actually. Really feel like we got a lot of those.
I'm not complaining.
No, nor am I. It gave us some very exciting games. I mean, Misfits and Humo went... I mean, they took it a bit too serious.
Yeah, they took it way too far.
But it's been fun. It's been really, really fun day of games. Pentakill as well from Caps in the previous game. This time around, a little bit more subdued. 1-4-2 because not really had the chance. Karma needs those extended team fights, and simply put, Nerva dead before he can get a second rotation of spells off.
Ooh, Joko.
Joko's got a black shield. Masterwork, right place, right time. Rest of Millennium. Vision is good. Teleport available for Kaze. Baron, round 7. Fight!
And as you say that, Joko slams down his axe. Wants to fight it. Joko again is... Kaze again is pushing down in the bottom side. Millennium is just dragging Nerve away. Thing is, Kaze is not really going to be able to push up to the tower. I don't know whether he can take Wicked and the tower. Although, that is a 2-level advantage for Kaze right now.
Still been the same. 75 CS advantage approaching Flame Horizon. 30 minutes on the clock. Ash Arrow catches onto Sir Nuxalot, decides not to flash away. Stand behind me. Joko's got Ragnarok on. Trundle Pillar comes down, slowing down Millennium's advance. The rest of Nerve are able to escape. After the Mantra Inspire.
Defiance.
Thank you. Manages to get them out clean and safe.
Sometimes I know the secondary ones.
It's good.
They are tough, though.
Yeah, Soul Flare is the Q. And I have no idea what the W was. I'll double check. It's renewal. It's renewal. Inspire and renewal. Which makes sense.
Makes sense.
You get more hit points.
Yeah. Get the W, the healing.
Elder Dragon. Thank you, observers.
Nice.
A very cute butterfly.
That's
a dragonfly. Butterflies to the left and back. Down, down, down a little more. Down a little more. There we go. See
sitting it's on the tree.
Yay. We taught Kevin something.
Oh, maybe we should name Butterfly Kevin instead of the Owl.
No, I think the Owl deserves to be Kevin. Okay. I mean, you know, we can't, it's sacrilege to go against the vote.
We can't go against the vote.
Yeah.
That's the unfortunate scenario. Now we are looking at a bird. Basically, the David Attenborough show right here, just in case. Planet Earth.
Yeah, you can do the voice much better than I can.
I can't do David Attenborough's. That is a cherished and treasured voice, Trevor. Yeah. I'm not going to try and imitate it.
Good. I'm glad you have a modicum of respect. Red buff secured by Joko.
Is that for just one person, or you mean...
No, just for him.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, yeah. Baron attempt seems to be setting up. Now for Millennium, looking at
the
inventory.
Where is it?
Looking.
Oh,
Memento gets stunned twice. Memento's down. Very good shield. We'll buy time for Memento body slam away. Nuxord is in trouble down south, and Joko's looking to run down Memento. They've traded one for one. Kaze dies. He bit off more damage than he was able to tank up. Upset is putting the hurt down on Joko and Pretty looking to death ray him up. They end up trading one for two. In favor of Millennium.
Is this finally the opening Millennium needed to try and get themselves the Baron here? Joko may be very low, but he's Olaf. He's going to be able to tank it up for a long time while he's low. Here comes the TP. It's Caps appearing into this. Wicked's here as well.
Wicked's looking for the steal. He's flashed forward. Baron's taking some damage. Millennium secure Baron. They take down Wicked. And I don't think they're done just yet. Oh, Caps has got the movement speed to escape. Nerve, they donate another kill to the Millennium cause. 9,000 gold advantage, a Baron, 4 dragons, a
consular?
No, it's not the word I'm looking for. Consolation prize!
Yay! Console.
Yeah, a consolation tower.
Okay. I was going to say, what, the Millennium consulate or something? I didn't really know what was going on that one.
Yeah, I struggled to find the words. I really struggled to find the words. I just feel like Millennium are so far ahead.
They're about to close the game, man.
With Baron, it's not the most brave prediction you've ever made, Stress.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn. What is? Do we know? Do you remember?
No.
Okay. Oh, we're about to Flame Horizon.
Are we?
Kazay is 98 CS up. So here was the engage on Memento. Double stun.
So where does Kazay go down? Right, he's just knocked over into three damage dealers.
He's in three, and he needed the reset off the Q on Memento actually dying so that he could kind of move around. That's the problem with Aurelia, being a reset champion. If you don't get the first one, it's kind of tough
Wicked gets flame horizoned by Kazay, and Kazay
captures
down. Kazay is running Wicked's signature champion. Irelia from first blood of this game. Just completely snowballed a hit. Caps was taken out under the inhibitor turret mid. Memento's trying to run for his life, buying as much time as possible. Upset will go down. The death ray takes him out. Wicked is subjugating, but it simply doesn't matter. He can't stand toe-to-toe in the Millennium composition. Memento's the only man standing. And the rest of Nerve are taken down. Millennium bounce back from a game one defeat where they conceded the pentakill. They conceded the possibility of taking first, but they grabbed themselves a point and even up the series of Nerve.
Much better game coming out from Millennium in that scenario.
Oh, yes.
Oh, man. That was a good start. I mean, they get the 1v4 pick, transition it into a couple more picks out on the map, get themselves up to a point. I think they were like 4-1. And from there, it was fairly straightforward. There were a couple of times where Nerve was starting to fight back, but I just didn't feel like with such a hamstrung, you know, solo lane setup, very tough to actually fight back.
The thing that I really liked from Millennium that game is they didn't press further than their advantage allowed. You know, they got two Mountain Drakes in a row and then went, let's play the Baron game. We know we can take it. If Nerve mess up their vision or if Nerve are late, they can secure the objective. And maybe it's a little more passive than we would have wanted in our sixth game of the day.
Yeah.
But on the same token, I think you have to admire the control and the strategy side of it that goes into it.
Yeah, I think it worked a lot better perhaps than expected. Yeah. But it's very weird that like both teams won with similar kind of setup from game one and two.
Yeah.
Like, very weird that it was more the team comp style for both teams. This were wildly different, but the wins were on the Olaf, the Ashe, that kind of...
Yeah, the same sort of champions.
Kind of comps. Very strange. Very, very weird, but cool.
There's also so much to go back to in terms of the drawing board, because Caps, I do not think he had a great series. I think the Aurelion Sol, yes, you got a pentakill, but the 30 minutes leading up to it was a little questionable.
Mm.
Maybe it's harsh to talk about the Karma game when the rest of his team has died around him. That's a bit of a challenge as well, but something that he needs to step up if he wants to compete, especially looking forward towards playoffs.
Yeah, that is definitely something we have to look at. Looking at other players that we can see, I mean, Joko had a better game now. I feel like the last couple of weeks you've been looking at him and I've been kind of rough on some of his picks. The Rek'Sai, which he previously was very good on, right now. The Olaf looked good with the right setup. Still kind of don't know where he's at compared to when we saw him in the LCS, because he actually had a decent run with the Unicorns for a couple of weeks in spring.
It's tough to judge, right? Because a game like this, actually a series like this, where you have really even but kind of weird swingy fights in game one, and then game two is determined by so many early picks.
Yeah.
The game just runs away with you almost regardless of the comps or the champions that you're running. But yeah, in the bigger picture, this means that Millennium are now officially out of the running. Millennium, they do secure their playoff spot, so they're guaranteed the postseason, and Misfits are guaranteed number one. Technically, every other team can still make it, depending on next week's results.
Out of the running for first.
Thank you.
Otherwise, people are like, wait, how did Millennium... No, out of the running for first.
Thank you.
They're still on track for a playoff spot.
Yeah.
So, Huma and Forge and Millennium have a chance for second is a thing. Still a lot of options available there for second.
Yeah, there really is a lot. And next week's games will be very interesting, especially taking a look at how Millennium and Misfits will go head-to-head. If I remember that's correctly the matchup, I'll double-check that. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Nerve take on Epsilon, so that's a battle
real
for the bottom.
Real important game.
And the thing that's really interesting about that is whoever wins that, depending on what happens with Forge and Huma, one of those teams could overshoot.
Yes. We're in a weird situation where, like, because of today's results with Forge, Epsilon Well, but Epsilon and Nerve can't both make it through.
No, only one. Whoever wins that series.
That series. If it's split.
If that series is split, I think they're both screwed.
I think it's if it's split, like Forge, as long as they pick up one game win, I believe is okay.
If it's split, Forge are already on 4 points.
Mm-hmm.
So if next week between Nerve and Epsilon split, they will only end up on 3 points.
Ah, so yeah.
So they literally, if they draw, they're both out.
Okay.
So a lot to play for. A lot to play for. It's always exciting when every series actually determines seeding and outcome. But then the thing is, even if you win the honor of facing Misfits in the semifinals.
Maybe not always the gold prize.
No.
But then again, that is what happens when you get fourth, right?
not the gold. the alternative is, if you play the strongest team earlier and you beat them, in theory, you should then win the whole thing.
If
you want to actually win, if you actually want to take the title and go into the promotion tournament with the highest seed, you have to beat the strongest teams. To give you guys an update, we are trying to get an interview. And I believe once it is set up, we will be talking to Masterworks. So give us a few... It is set up, I am hearing. Thank you very much.
I was trying to tell you.
Masterwork, how are you doing, man?
Hello. I'm doing fine. Thank you.
Fantastic, fantastic. Congratulations on a very convincing game two. Let's talk about game one, maybe, because I think it was a little bit more close. What happened in that game that ended up in you guys, you know, actually losing to that Aurelion Sol composition?
I don't think we played our comp right. Like, I think we kind of failed in the draft. We didn't take the picks we wanted to go for. And in the end, we played a comp we didn't really want to go for. So in the end, we didn't know how to play it well. So we made mistakes at the Dragon where Aurelion Sol got the Penta kill. And like, we had to play safe on the turrets all the game. So it was not really our play style. And they managed to play really well and win the game.
It looked like in game one, you guys struggled a little with the Ashe and the Zyra. What's your take on that bottom lane? Because we're seeing more and more of those two picks together.
Well, simply because I picked Braum. And as Braum, you don't really have the 2v2 power in the lane against the Zyra Ashe. So that was the risk we took by picking Braum Karma. Like, instead, we should have maybe gone Karma Flex pick and not pick the Braum. And it's just really hard to lane against that if you have no pressure from your jungler or top laner. And in the end, like, they got three turrets and they kept on getting objectives. And they managed to build up a big advantage because of that.
Yeah, it was a very good team fighting from you guys, though, in the mid-game to pull it back. I want to ask a little bit more about some of the champions. Today, we've seen Shen become like first pick priority for nearly every single team, even banned away in that last game. What is so special about Shen right now amongst the challenger teams that has shot him so up the priority list?
I think one of the reasons is because a lot of mid laners right now don't run the teleport summoner spell. And because of that, Shen can pressure more lanes, which the mid laner without TP can't do. And besides that, it's a very good laner itself, and it puts pressures on every lane, and it's really easy to split push and take no risks. So it's a really strong first pick. So I can understand it being first pick right now.
Yeah, definitely.
And from what I understand, in Korea, they're first picking it as well. So
yeah, it must be good,
that's
right?
I know about it. Yeah, exactly.
Masterwork, next week you guys face off against Misfits. Now, unfortunately, you can't challenge for first place anymore.
Yes.
What is that series going to mean to you, knowing that you guys are, you know, in the playoffs, but now you're battling for seeding?
I'm not sure how the seeding goes. Like, our main plan is to go top three. And against Misfits, we will just prepare as much as we can. And we got a lot of to prepare for, and I think we can beat them. I really see the chances.
All right. Well, thank you so much for the interview. I wish you best of luck next week against Misfits and looking forward to seeing how you perform in the playoffs.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Masterwork. Nice to hear. And I quite like hearing players when they're quite critical. In game one, we made mistakes. We didn't play a comp. Maybe picks and bans. So there's a number of like reasons you can go into. And it's just a matter of fixing it for next time.
Yeah, and it's one of those situations where you look back at it and you think, if, as he said, maybe if it was the flex camera instead of the Braum, and they changed it up for game two and it works out a lot better for them. Yeah. So glad to see Millennium at least picking up a win here. I think a 2-0 actually may have kind of rocked Millennium. We know they're a team that have struggled a little bit when it came to, the tip-top games when we look at playoffs last split, so I'm hoping that they can maintain a level of consistency here. That's one of the discussions we had about Tabs coming in. Hopefully we can see a Millennium maintain that kind of level from game two as we go forward towards their series against Misfits.
Yeah, we've talked a lot about the standings. Let's actually quickly take a look at the table. As we've mentioned already, Misfits, they guarantee themselves first, thanks to Nerf picking up that upset victory over Millennium earlier tonight. You got Millennium on 6 points, Huma 5, Forge on 4 points, EPS and Nerv 2 apiece. And all five of the remaining teams can technically still qualify for playoffs.
Yes. So next week's shows are going to be super important. Some great games coming out. So remember to tune in again next week. We'll start with Millennium versus Misfits. That'll be at the same time on Tuesday at 5 p.m. CEST.
Yes, this time without me, unfortunately. Then it will be Nerv taking on Epsilon, and we'll round it out with Forge versus Huma. Each of those are actually very important because they literally determine seeding. And if Forge go down, that's how Epsilon and Nerv get their shot to make it into the top four.
That is. But if you want to check the schedule, the standings, anything else, whether it's mid lane week focused or you want to check out where EU Finals is going to be for Summer Split, hint, it's Krakow in Poland.
It's not a hint, that's the answer.
Hey, sometimes a hint's the answer. EU.lollysports.com, that's where you can find out all of that information.
Yes, it is. Well done. Remember, tomorrow night, PTL will be kicking off. If you're a night owl, if you're up late, be sure to check it out. I will also be on that show, and I might be wearing this shirt.
Wow. Are you a time traveler, or you just don't do laundry? Is that what happens?
Both.
Both. Nice. After that, for PTL, if you're still a night owl, in which case you're either in America or you really have a bad sleep schedule, North American Challenger kicks off as well for their week four.
Yes, let's hope they have as many fun games and potentially pentakills. I hope you guys enjoyed the quick shot and stress edition of European Challenger Series from myself, himself, the entire broadcast team, themselves. Good night, and don't forget to feed your poros.
Oh,
Flash Cocoon, Koskyu's dead. First blood picked up.
On something that isn't running TP in this scenario, it's the Cassiopeia. Here they go.
Oh, look at that. Mimic flashes over the wall. Ooh. Pins Koskyu up against the tower before taking him down. Mimic gets taken out by the poison of Koskyu before Kyrie is forced to run away. Sand United will deliver Sartorius to the fight. No, it gets interrupted. Mimic's bought some time, but it will not matter. Three members of Forge are down, and Epsilon have everything they need to close this game out. I can remember has no flash available. Stand United is being channeled. It will complete. The taunt comes under the tower, and Kyrie's taken down for first blood.
In this situation, I'll play by play this one.
Look at flash that! In. Flash over, Woolite's in trouble. Ike unleashes power all over Woolite's face.
They can't miss no good wards.
Noxia's gonna flash away. Oh, the shot gets him. Koskyu didn't tank it. Mimic taunts and flashes after. Woolite's locked down. He follows shortly thereafter. Epsilon have lost two. The base is open. Heva catches out Koskyu, and Forge turn their attention to the inhibitor. His igniter is available. Flash away. Double flash forward. Chrisland's in trouble. Hunt Summit down to 100. The minions might kill him. And it's a last auto attack from Wendelbo. Continues to chase Alfari and Hunt Summer. He wants catnip. Flashes forward, will not find this. Chrisland is taunted up. Essence Flux takes him down. And Huma, they bit off way more than they could chew.
Swim's just, I'm going to run with my head.
I love wisdom.
Down.
I love wisdom waiting at the back of the pit.
This is a cage roll.
Someone's coming over, and when they do, I'm sinking my fangs in. Well, Selfie's chasing forward. Chaos Storm's already been used in a very good cosmic binding. First blood secured by Selfie. Second blood secured by Selfie too. Unlucky for Huma as Impaler is about to be impaled. He's gonna get knocked down. Dancing Grenade, I think, just about does it. Protobelt forward. Screw the Baron. We want the kills. Misfits take down Wendelbo. And they've got a team comp that's just going to, like, kill Chrisman like this.
He's dead.
Hey, turn their attention to JWoww. Three members of Huma are down. Wisdom in a death ray. Set their sights in JWoww. And Chrisman's doing a little dance as he runs away. Misfits, 27 kills in 32 minutes.
as Joko catches two.
Oh, that was a great barrel. All of a sudden, Upset is taken down. So Nuxalot puts down the Stranglethorns. That'll buy some time. Enough for Memento to arrive. And a body slam flash from Joko secures the second kill. That's a double for Tabs. After throwing everything at Millennium, but it's not done yet.
Oh, he got caps. Oh, Tabs manages to pick him up. Just, oh, here we go.
Yay.
Yes. What? Oh.
Yep. Upset is not yet. A 5 versus 4. Caps is on the wrong side of the team. He steals it. Celestial Expansion, or I think the Voice of Light, takes it down. The Caps gets a kill into Joko. The Celestial Expansion is ticking damage away. That's a triple. That's a quadra. Looking for more. This could be a penta kill. It's secured by Caps on Aurelion Soul.